those voices?
Yes, where am I? I figured that if I got to the bottom, I'd be standing, but apparently.
I know this place. I've been here before.
Door? Clock? Definitely a dream. Definitely going with a dream. Tobble.
I've been here my entire life. I'm trapped in here.
Lantern. Staircase.
These stairs. I'm climbing these stairs again.
I guess technically you're climbing them. It's more like you're stroking by them.
I need to get out. The voices are calling me.
Who is in the chair?
I have to get it. I have to.
Wakey wakey time? Yep.
Those horrible dreams again. I've had them repeatedly ever since my mother died and left me that music box in her will. Harry always said that old family heirloom had something to do with my family's strange disease. If the doctors won't give us an answer about your illness, I'll search for one myself, you said. And in that search, it seems you lost yourself. I don't think I'd ever...
Pardon me, madam, but the island is in sight. We'll be lowering the boat in just a minute.
Oh, thank you so much, Captain Hodgson. I'll be right out. All right. Time to gather my things.
Definitely gonna need your diary.
Right. The amazing adventures of Nora Everhart, art teacher.
Alright, Nora, remember this. This is your house. Okay, after 3 days of begging, I've managed to convince Captain Hodgins to take me close to the island. Save your money, Miss Everhart. Leaving me alone will be payment enough. I think there's a sweet, tender heart inside that grumpy old sailor. Definitely gonna need gloves.
Oh, I'd better cover up my hands before I leave the cabin. I wouldn't want anyone thinking I'm a circus freak. I received a mysterious package at my house. I stored all its contents in my locked suitcase.
One package. Delivered.
I always dreamed of traveling. I was not the same without you, Harry.
The SS Carmel. What was this large suitcase she was talking about?
It's a relief that I don't need it to walk anymore. What was I thinking when I brought all these dresses on this trip?
There we go.
I think I've overpacked.
Nope.
I've still got to pack up a few more things. Merveille de mer du Sud. Marvels of the Southern Seas, I think.
There we go.
Oh my, I have the worst memory. I forgot the combination again.
506.
Thank goodness I always bring my journal with me to write things down.
Boom.
All right, now it's open.
So we got
Harry Everhart, my husband, my partner, and my dear old pal. A brass key with the letters CW engraved on it, and some enigmatic instructions. This strange and sharp relic came in the package I received at home. I saw this island in one of my unsettling dreams. I drew it as soon as I woke up.
We're all set, madam. The motor boat is ready.
Then let's do this.
Okay, Nora. From here on out, you're on your own.
Lower the motorboat. Be careful with Mrs. Everhart's equipment, lads. We'll be back to pick you up in 3 days. I really hope you find your husband there, madam.
I hope it too. I'll see you in 3 days then.
But please be careful on that island. You know what the legends say about it.
I'll take care. Thank you, Captain Hudson. Well, here I am, in the middle of the ocean after traveling across half the world. Just miles away from where my husband is supposed to be. You left a year ago to search for a cure for my affliction. Your letters kept me close to you, but suddenly they stopped coming. What happened, old pal? What did you find? Whatever it was, it led you to hire a crew and set sail from San Francisco to Tahiti. And from there, to this place. An island in the middle of the Pacific that the locals refused to even name. Everything is familiar. So familiar. As impossible as that may sound. Is this the island I dreamed about? This can't be a coincidence. Idyllic island, surrounded by deadly reefs and protected with stakes to keep anybody from entering. Why?
Humongous monsters, that's why.
There's definitely something strange about this place. Okay, Harry. Let's see if I can find any trace of you around here. I know it's just resonance, but I do love listening to the sea in them. A tent. So somebody was on this island recently. This machete is completely worn down. The blade is dull.
What do we got there?
A note written in French. I only understand two words. Île and mort. Island and death.
Where's this South Pacific expedition, I would guess?
It must be a warning about the dangers of the island. Well, that's a vivo, a flute that the Polynesians play with their nose. I won't be playing that.
No sense of adventure.
A miniature va'a, a Polynesian outrigger canoe. Beautifully crafted, too.
That must be the scabbard for the machete.
I feel quite good. I dare say I might even walk a little faster than usual. Those markings seem to represent the sea. I'll make a note of them in my journal. It might come in handy.
Oh, there's three of them.
An offering of mother of pearl. Quite valuable for the Polynesians.
Alright, so there's definitely Polynesians on this.
Looks like it opens from the other side.
Damn.
These wooden figures are called Unu. This seems to be telling a story.
Nothing on the backside, okie dokie.
A bone fish hook.
Slightly creepy. Oops, missed the stairs.
It may look peaceful, but clearly somebody wants to keep outsiders off this island. What a lovely flower offering.
This one looks like the people are lowering one of their own to feed the monster.
A carving tool. This box. CW. Those are the initials on the brass key. It opens it. So whoever sent me this key was here.
I know exactly where this is.
This is starting to look like a scavenger hunt.
You think? I mean, come on now. There you are.
Well, look what's hidden here.
I'll take that Thank you. Let's see what the other guys do. They let one of them go on a boat. It's like they had attacked people who showed up. And looks like for the most part they're gonna die.
Polynesians don't need doors. So why build such a big one?
There we go.
Well, that did something.
Open sesame.
This may be the first time I trespass a private property. My childhood in Newburyport wasn't exactly the most thrilling thing. Is that Harry? Harry, you were here! You were here and I found you, dammit. Where are you now? Where is everybody? Where did you and all your crew go? Lady Shannon? That name sounds familiar. I'd better check my journal.